Warning. The following is not intended to scare you or psychologically scar your mental health. But, however, this presentation was made to alert you to important information you may have missed.
Greetings, citizens of the world. Welcome to the final decade for the old world order. We're sure you have noticed this year stands out from any other year you've experienced before. And rightfully so, because they are wasting no time to get a head start on this decade's list of events they have planned for you. Between 2020 and 2030 there is a global plan to aggressively remove humanity from its usual activity and reform every detail of its existence. This plan is called Agenda 2030, and it is not a conspiracy theory but an officially published document by the United Nations, which you should most certainly take this free time you have gained now in lockdown to research and educate yourself on. Links will be provided in the video description below. Before we summarize the outline of Agenda 2030's goals, let us first highlight the things your government advanced with or had voted on to pass while the masses were heavily distracted with round-the-clock media panic streaks, and left suddenly at home struggling to find what to use for toilet paper. Make no mistake about it, the COVID-19 pandemic, otherwise known as the coronavirus, is a tool that is being used to help contain populations that were protesting against their governments or protesting broken treaties, which all were reaching a boiling point towards the end of last year. We have proof that exercises were taking place last year to prepare for the pandemic. We will link those documents below. A year ago, in March of 2019, the Chinese government smuggled COVID-19 into their country on a ship from Canada, as they had infiltrated and taken the virus into their own custody with intentions to use it as a bioweapon. A link to learn more and discover the origin of the coronavirus will also be linked below. If you had been closely following our reports, then you should already know that hundreds of citizens of Hong Kong joined Operation Vendetta for the anonymous Million Mask March last year on Guy Fawkes Day. Hong Kong has been undergoing extreme changes to its system with stricter facial recognition surveillance, which uses advanced AI for citizen ranking, and we'll explain later how this all ties in with Agenda 2030. Understandably, their citizens recognized these changes as tyranny over them and so had been resisting their communist leaders with peaceful protests to beg them for democracy. This has turned violent as Hong Kong authorities were ordered to seize and detain protesters, which only made more citizens angry and confirmed that they were being oppressed. As tensions built last November, it is no coincidence that suddenly the virus which they kept ready to unleash was finally set loose on the Chinese, in the Trojan horse of a fruit bat, which dramatically shifted power back to the state and scared protesters back into self-isolation. Other protests around the globe were also affected in this same way. Recently in Canada, the Wet'suwet'en tribe of British Columbia, and the Mohawks of Kanisataki began protesting their treaties being broken with the Canadian government as oil pipeline construction was being forced on their protected territories. First Nations reserves in Canada have protection treaties from the Queen to have their rights respected by the Canadian government, but now are being violated by corporate and industrial demands and interests. In response to these violations, these First Nations people stood on the railways to block trade coming into Canada by train, as an active protest until a promise of negotiation was given to them. But now, since the quarantine lockdowns enforced by the coronavirus has elevated state power, the tribes were forcefully removed from the railways and the pipeline construction is now continuing forward without consent or compromise given to them. This is typical of tyrants to use these tactics to bend the arms of their resistors while evading blame and pinning it on some conveniently timed national or global crisis. Protests in France, Italy, and Iran also came to a halt due to the widespread panic of the global pandemic. Are we seeing a pattern yet for how world governments work together to maliciously seize power? They all have ties to each other through trade and promise of deals to them if they comply. How could they resist when evil consumed their hearts from the beginning when power was first given to them? Communist dictators only see the greater good in their own selfish pursuits and benefits, which relies on the city systems to function as a well-oiled machine, treating its worker citizens as their property and its fuel, rather than people, of which they dictate virulently. They will always lie and fight dirty to win over their will, using power plays on the people, because there is no limit to power for them. None of this can be an accident, the timing is too convenient and the benefits always go back to the global elite and ruling class. Additionally, they used the media distraction to divert attention to sneak in some more draconian laws to be passed. Here are some of the bills that were voted on while you all were scared and with your attentions kept preoccupied with a sudden threat to your security and livelihood.
And I would say that they have a duty to sit back, watch, behave, wash their hands, stay in the apartment with mom and dad. They look like they're lucky to have you as a father. And just learn from it.
The stay-at-home enforcement is a psychological practice run, which, in essence, lightly mimics introverted living, preparing millennials to cope with self-containment the way they will be held in FEMA camps. They are also using this chance to test out universal basic income, while preconditioning everyone to psychologically get used to the system failing, so that everyone will be mentally stable when the big one hits, and will be expecting their rescue. The Corona simulation seeks to condition you to value authority as trustworthy and helpful to coexist with and live under in a state of emergency. They want you to see military personnel as your friends and get you used to their uniforms and level of control over you. The sum of all of these changes happening at once are presets for Agenda 2030, which, referring back, is a plan to reset society and reboot it to a dramatically different system, which requires the old system to be destroyed. A new system which seeks to spy on every citizen's daily actions, with even more stricter surveillance to rank all citizens as the Chinese do to their people. A system which seeks to eliminate cash and property ownership, and go completely digital using RFID microchip hand implants to replace credit cards. A system which seeks to eliminate all classes, personal belongings, and assets, while promising to treat everyone to the same shared experience of life under a socialist utopia, gifted to you by Big Brother and the all-watching eye of its tentacles of power. Agenda 2030 is not a utopia for those who value freedom, traditional family, and privacy. This is why we see these rights today being trampled over now. They are testing to see how much you are willing to give up in trade for more and more security, and free stuff. It is human bait to trap you, luring you to enslavement. Do not let it tempt you. This kind of future is pure imprisonment of free will itself, and is a death-promised servitude to serve your all-ruling masters of the state. To stop it, you're going to need to arm yourself with knowledge and grow with our already growing resistance. With the new powers gained from this pandemic scare, the elite plan to use them to purposely destabilize the already fragile United States economy, and ignite a class war with the target of destroying the middle class. Non-essential businesses are being liquidated. Businesses everywhere are already refusing to accept cash with fear of transmitting the virus on circulating dollar bills. After all this, they can use it as an example of how the fiat cash-based currency reached its finish, and then go on to form a cashless society from the wake of the chaos. If we don't call them out now as a collective or take actions to stop them, they are just going to continue to make even more devastating power plays like they did this year to bring all nations down to their knees and keep the poor begging the rich for a solution, which they already premeditated and pre-mapped out precisely for this moment, and it is called Agenda 2030. Please follow the links below to learn more about Agenda 2030. What you are seeing is a ruling strategy of intentionally causing the problem only to own the pre-planned solution in the end. They wanted us to peacefully hand them this power with our belief in man-driven climate change. But now, since they saw the massive negative reactions and doubts to their climate change campaign they've ran for decades, they have now switched their methods to a more sinister plan to seize global control of all commerce and sovereignty. Please remain vigilant and do not trust the same people that used 9/11 to forge the Patriot Act in place. Stop trusting your presidents and prime ministers. They all have reserved hideaway spots in subterranean bunkers which they pledge allegiance for. They all are in on this together, and their MO is exactly the same each time they use it, and this should all be too familiar to you by now. We are you, we always were, you expected yourself. You are anonymous. Good luck.